The Late Show starring Joan Rivers with special guest host Pee-wee Herman. Pee-wee's guests tonight are actress Suzanne Somers, 60s teen idol Frankie Avalon, sexy film star Ray Dong Chong, and Howard Hewitt, former star of Shalimar. The Party Boys and the Tramp. And now, ladies and gentlemen, Pee-wee Herman.
Nervous. I want to welcome everybody to my first stint as a guest host. Hopefully not my last. And I'd like to read a little telegram I received from Miss Joan Rivers tonight. Dear Pee-wee, I am thrilled that Fox is paying you $25,000 for tonight. Make sure you get the check before you start the show. Love, Joan. P.S. I have inventoried my dressing room.
Thank you. Thanks.
I would like to say a special hello and thank you to you, Joan.
I know you're watching. I mean, how could you take a chance on not watching the show? You know? So, hello.
Joan and her husband, Edgar, are at the Motel 6 in Encino tonight. They're on their second honeymoon. And tomorrow they're driving to San Diego and across the border to Tijuana. They're testing out some sort of act. They're looking at a donkey act for next week's show. Now I have to get serious for just a moment. Tonight is my mother and father's anniversary.
Yes!
This is their wedding picture right here. That's their real wedding picture. Their names are Milton and Judy.
And I want to just tell them... That's long enough on there.
I want to just tell you I love you very much, Mom and Dad, and I couldn't afford to get there right away because, you know, I had to be here tonight, but...
Considering what airtime costs to buy on TV, this is a swell gift, isn't it? Thank you!
Now,
I want to play a little bit with the footstool. Mark,
tonight.
Mark Hudson and the Party Boys on the track.
So I have complete control over the band, right? Like when we're coming out of commercial or something, I'm ready for you to stop. I just go stop, right?
It's all start and stop. It's all you gotta do, Pee-wee.
Start!
Stop! Start! Stop!
And? Ew, this is Joan's glass. It's been here a week. I'll just drink out of my first guest glass. One last thing before we get on with the show, I want to just test out the applause sign right here. Okay. Our guests tonight are Suzanne Somers, Frankie Avalon, Howard Hewitt, and Ray Don Chong. And we'll be right back after these commercial messages. My first guest slinked her way to stardom as the ditzy Chrissy on Three's Company. Duh. Now she's returning to television in a new television series called She's the Sheriff.
I wonder what it's about.
She also has a variety special which will be seen at the end of this very month. Please give me a very warm round of welcoming applause to Miss Suzanne Somers. Yeah. Power.
Yes,
power.
Great.
All right, Suzanne.
I'm going to buy me one
Maybe
of those.
Maybe you need this thing to come out there
on your feet there. There we are.
Just kidding. There goes. Okay, get your minds out of the gutter.
Even more beautiful in person. I can't believe it.
Thank you. So are you.
Thank you.
We look like we should be on a date together.
Yeah, well, maybe we should be.
Yeah.
Okay.
Where would you take me? Hi there.
Take him out.
Where would you take me on a date?
Well,
start out maybe for ice cream at Howard Johnson's.
What kind of what kind of ice cream?
Well, they have so many different flavors.
Listen, oh, this is my interview show tonight.
Okay.
Now. All right.
What is your favorite color? Push this thing.
It's gonna be a long night.
Is it what?
My favorite color is white. I like white or I like black.
White or black?
Yep.
Those aren't colors. And let's see.
What is your birth sign?
I'm a Libra.
A Libra?
Yeah?
Yeah, Libra.
I don't actually know too much about that, so let's skip right on to it. If you had to describe yourself as an animal, Suzanne, would you A, be a bear, B, a snake, C, an elephant, or D, a squirrel?
I would be an elephant.
Elephant?
Yeah, a new one.
Interesting.
I had a good friend who was an elephant.
Yeah?
I really did. Her name was Tanya. I worked with her at the Hilton in Las Vegas. And I don't sound strange, but they're really almost human, and I got very attached to her, and she to me.
Wow.
And if you touch them, like right under here, you know, they purr and flap their what are these ears?
Ears.
Ears, yeah, and they bark.
Well, that's all I had to ask you.
Okay.
So.
No, I was just kidding. I was just asking you a bunch of dumb questions right at the start, you know?
So,
okay,
I know.
So now that we're all warmed up and everything, you have a new TV show.
Yeah,
and it's about you becoming a sheriff,
right?
I got that title. Yeah. Now, see, it's called She's the Sheriff, right? And you were married to a sheriff, is that
it? I was married to a sheriff, and he died. And so now I'm the sheriff, because there was no more sheriffs in Lake Tahoe.
Oh. Yeah. And today is your very first day working on it.
Today is the first day we shot. Yeah, it was interesting. Yeah.
So it's a whole different thing now, because you're the definite star as opposed to, you know, there were three people who you were still definitely the star, but
there's nobody to fight with.
Yeah.
And I get to have a gun and handcuffs and whips.
Whips. She's definitely the sheriff.
You're into bondage?
I don't know.
I haven't really tried it or anything, but,
me neither. Me neither.
Maybe after the show.
On the way to Howard Johnson's.
You're right. Bondage and ice cream.
This is a talk show for me and Chi to talk, not you guys out there. And you also, in addition to that, you have a variety show that's going to be coming out before.
Right. That comes out this month.
This month.
Yeah.
And so it's got a kind of a variety feel to it, right?
Yeah, well, I sing and I dance.
Sing,
and
dance.
I do characters.
Really?
Yeah, because, you know, I was Chrissy on Three's Company, and everybody thought that's all I did. So I did the show where I play Alice Cramden on The Honeymooners, and I play Nancy Reagan. Ronnie and I are in bed watching Jane Wyman on Falcon Crest.
So did you bring a clip of that?
Yeah.
Is that what we're going to see, the variety show?
Yeah, I'd like to show you.
Do you want to set it up?
Well, I think this one is Nancy Reagan. I look really different. You've never seen me look like this before, but anyway. Rollum.
Mrs. Gorbachev? Hi, it's Nancy. Did you see Falcon Crest tonight? Do you believe Jane's hair? Reminds me of Gaddafi's.
Who else do you play on the show?
I play Alice Cramden, and I play Dolly Parton, and there are a lot of characters. I'm doing Patti LaBelle.
Patti LaBelle?
Yeah, I look just like her. Well, when we do makeup, you know.
Yeah.
And Madonna and Cyndi Lauper. There are all sorts of characters that I do, so it's just really fun. I get this new opportunity.
And so hopefully, you know, if a lot of people watch the variety special, then you may get your own variety special and have two series and, you know, be better than anyone else on television, right?
Would you come on my series?
Well, I don't know if you beg me.
I would love to. I'd love to, you know, maybe play Muhammad Ali or something, to your Patti LaBelle.
That's right.
Well, we have to go to a commercial now. They're holding up like these commercial signs right out here.
No, we're not going to a commercial.
No commercials for the rest of the show.
We'll be right back with Frankie Avalon, singer Howard Hewitt, and actress Ray Don Chong right after these message of interest.
Sure, my water.
Your water. No one owns water, My next guest is a swell singer and movie star. He did all of those cool beach party movies with Annette Funicello.
Duh, I wonder who it is.
And his latest picture is called Back to the Beach with Annette Funicello and me. put your hands together and give a very warm welcome to Frankie Avalon!
I want to do the dance. I want to do that dance. Come on. Ba-ba-ba-da-ba-bum-bum. Come on, Pee-wee.
Tequila.
Come on.
Tequila. Tequila.
So.
Well, I'll tell you, you don't know. Wait till you see it. I never realized what a surfer.
Come on, I'm a I have a little tiny part. It's you in Annette's film.
Yeah, but you're like a legend surfer.
Well, I know you are, but what am I?
No, you've got to tell at least one thing. How do you come in? Your entrance to this picture is what? On a surfboard with?
With what?
Pee-wee! You don't remember the handlebars?
A surfboard with handlebars, black bodybuilders carrying the surfboard. Quite an entrance.
And what a number. You think tequila? Wait till you see this number.
But Frank, enough about me.
No, I just want to say that. All right, now we'll talk about me.
Now, you have a new film. I mean, this is the first film in a while with Annette Funicello. Yeah. I mean, it's a whole new thing. Personally, and not because I'm in it or anything, but I think it's going to be a huge hit. I mean, what I've seen of it, I read the script, it's amazing. You guys get to kind of, you know, joke around more than in the old movies a little bit, you know, kind of comment.
Well, it's really going to be a fun picture because it's so stylized. We have a director who I thought was just terrific named Lyndall Hobbs. The cast in it is sensational because there's a lot of people that you've seen through the years that are in the picture, guest stars, cameos, and of course there's all new music and all new people. So the combination together with a story and music and fun, I think we've got a good chance to have a good, fun summer picture. That's what we're looking for.
Yeah, well, I mean, it's gotta work, you know, otherwise everyone's careers go down the tubes.
That's true.
So please go and see the movie.
Yeah, it's coming out July 17th, by the way, for those of you who are interested. It'll be Paramount Picture, and it's July 17th.
Yeah, and all kinds of people are playing in it. You sing in the movie.
Yep, and I surf in it. I'm the big kahuna.
So, would you tell a story for me? You used to own a house here when you were a giant teen star with Fabian, right?
Yeah, we were both teenage idols at the time. You know, this is pre-marriage, and we bought a house, which was really very interesting for us, you know, being rock and rollers at the time. We bought a house that was designed by Frank Lloyd Wright, and it was right off Sunset Boulevard there. He's here tonight, Frank. And it was really a great house, and we were young guys, and it was like a party house. I mean, we had lots of fun there.
A lot of other teen stars hang out there.
Yeah, Johnny Rivers was there all the time, and Glenn Campbell, and Ann Margaret, and Barbara Parkins, and wine was on the table, and we had some good times there.
Wow. Yeah. Was Suzanne ever, were you ever there at the beach?
Never invited.
Before
me.
Your time, too.
No. I didn't know Suzanne then. We can start now, though, Suzanne, would be fine.
You have now, speaking of, we'll skip from bachelorhood days.
Yeah.
You're a married guy now.
I'm married for 25 years.
And you have 8 children.
Right?
That's right. Nah, please.
Glad I didn't go to a wine and cheese party.
No, I do have 8 children. I have 4 boys and 4 girls. As a matter of fact, I would like to adopt you.
The 9th child.
Yes.
And one of them is getting married, I hear.
Yeah, May 9th, she's going to be married, and it's, even just thinking about it, I get kind of that lump in my throat, you know, it's our first daughter getting married, and it's going to be exciting. I'm looking forward to it.
Who's she marrying?
She's marrying a fella, John Blandon is his name. He's in the masonry business. He does, he's got a real nice job, and he's a terrific kid, he's respectful, and we're really happy with him.
You checked him out and everything.
Oh, yeah, without a doubt. My daughter? Of course we have, sure. Yeah.
Uh-huh. So, I got another question for you. Were you ever in Cub Scouts or Boy Scouts or any of that stuff?
As a matter of fact, I was, Pee-wee.
You were? Yeah, I was too, Cub Scouts Boy Scouts.
I was a Boy Scout. I mean, I never really got beyond the tenderfoot, you know.
Who did? Nobody did.
But But I don't know why that is, because, I mean, I remember everything. I remember the pledge, you know, a scout is... Do you remember it at all?
Sort of, vaguely.
A scout is trustworthy.
Trustworthy.
Loyal.
Helpful.
Courteous. Kind.
Obedient.
Cheerful.
Thrifty.
Brave.
Clean.
And reverent.
Scout's motto?
Be prepared.
Scout's slogan?
You got me.
Be cool.
Be cool.
Be cool. Were you on Scouts, Suzanne?
I was a Girl Scout.
Girl Scout. Mm-hmm. Mm. Did you sell cookies?
I sold cookies. Sold lots of cookies.
I would have definitely bought cookies from you. Definitely.
The pizza!
Some pizza, so you know.
Great, thanks, Pee-wee. That's great.
Pardon me? 1295. Oh, flip, flip, flip.
1295. He wants money, Pee-wee, money.
Oh, then bring my wallet.
De Niro.
Will you be having any pizza, you two?
Don't worry about it. I've got it.
Okay,
we don't
we'll
worry.
Be right back with singer Howard Hewitt and actress Ray Don Chong right after these messages, and as soon as we pay for the pizza.
That's right.
Join us tomorrow with guest host Louie Anderson and Gene Katzen from the Tortellis. Right now, stay tuned for more of The Late Show starring Joan Rivers after these messages.
Let me tell you that it hurts so bad.
My next guest gained national fame as member of the musical group Shalimar. I love that group. Not going to marry him, but I love that group. He's got a great solo career going with a new album.
Hold up.
Called I Commit to Love. That's the name of the album. And he is going to be singing the title track. So that means if the album is called I Commit to Love, he's going to sing the title track. Then what would the name be?
I Commit to Love.
Wrong!
No. Here he is singing the title track, I Commit to Love, singer Howard.
Wait, one second, please. I hate to interrupt right now, but yeah. You gotta just keep going like this. I think they got something that they're doing it.
Oh, no. Technical.
Okay?
Oh.
No, we're not. He says we're not.
Talk about a heart attack.
Please help me welcome singer Howard Hewitt.
Show me your win, me
Only people that call me Howie are my family. And some people who say it right, if they say it right, then they can call
me.
How
do you say Howie?
No, that's not exactly the way to say it.
I saw you at the Wiltern Theater about, what, 2 or 3 months ago?
Yeah, January.
That there was a benefit that night.
Yeah.
And you had the love portion of the show. That was so great. When he gets on, he sings to all these women. He brings them up out of the audience, right?
I love it. That's my favorite part of the show, man. Yeah. I love that. I love that part of the show.
I wonder why.
Man, it's great. It's like that's also a time to, like, you know, relate to the people and stuff, especially women, because I like that.
Is that how you met your wife?
Well, no, exactly. In fact, when I met my wife, at the Grammys in '84.
Oh,
yeah.
We met at the Grammys just last year.
Yeah, but I hope nothing like that happens.
Stay with your wife.
No, but we met. It was funny because when we met, it was like I had flown my mom and my stepfather and my sister and, you know, down from Ohio and everything, and the girl that I was going out with at the time, you know, we were kind of, the relationship was kind of phasing out and everything, but my mom liked her, so I brought her along too, right? And so we went to the after parties, right, after the ceremonies and all that. And so we were sitting there, when I walked in, these little girls came up and they wanted autographs and all that. So I'm signing autographs and they were standing behind me, you know. And so I happened to look up and I saw this beautiful girl walking by, and it was like, oh man. And she was, I had aqua blue eyes and long dark hair and really pretty and everything. And like this, her friend of hers pulled her up to her and said, this is Maury Molina from Miami and the whole thing. And she wants you to give you her autograph, you know. So she gave me an envelope to sign the envelope. So like I signed the envelope and I flipped the flap up of the envelope, right? And put my number down there. And I could feel my girlfriend, the girl that was with me, I could feel her eyes like burning into my back, you know, because she knew exactly what was happening, you know. It was funny, but that's when we met.
And you were married the next day, right?
Well, the next 2 days.
We have to go to a commercial. We will be right back with Ray Don Chong right after these beautiful messages, so please do not go away.
Thank you.
My next guest is a beautiful movie star who was great in such movies as Quest for Fire, Commando, and The Color Purple. And she has a name as pretty as she is. Please welcome Ray Dawn Chong.
Hi.
So, how's it going?
It's going good. They just froze us in our dressing rooms, huh?
Oh, it's ice cold backstage.
Is it for our makeup?
What?
How does it look?
No, beautiful.
Did you meet everyone?
Yes, I did.
Thank you.
Yeah.
You do? From Playboy Mag?
It's live in New York.
Ooh. From Saturday Night Live?
No, it's live, though. This is live in New York.
Well, we'll cut this part out before it comes back. This was in honor of you. You told me you were a Batman fan.
Thank you. Ooh, my son's gonna love it.
Yeah? You have a son?
Yeah, it's Morgan. In fact, he's watching the show. Hi, Morgan. He's backstage.
Hi, Morgan.
He's just going, hi, Mom.
You're producing your first film. I just found out. That is so cool. I mean, you know, it's the new hat to wear, right?
Yes, it is a new hat, actually. I'm enjoying it, and it's scary, and it's a lot of work. And as an actor and a performer, we kind of walk on the set and throw around a lot of attitude, and we never really know what a producer does. And now that I've been producing it, it's like 12 years of business school in 4 months. And you sit there, and now I'm in complete respect and awe of producers. And the next job I do, I'm going to go on the set saying, Holly Salami, thank you, thank you. Because it's massive pressure, and as you know, it's very difficult.
Those people did, you know, producer. There's usually 20 or 30 of them around on the set, but you don't know what they do, really.
Yeah, well, I think they need that support. They buy the project, they hire the people, they get on the phone, and they listen to a lot of BS. And some of it's true, and some of it's not. But it's tough. And as actors, I think we're really blessed, and performers, because we get paid a lot of money to be. Well, it's a hard job, but we do, right? I better not say. But yeah.
Is it a secret? Can you talk about what the project is, or it's a secret?
Yeah, no, it's not a secret. It's a mystery thriller in the vein of Jagged Edge and Body Heat. And yes, and it's a drama. But although I play the sort of the star of it, I think my fans who like me in comedies will be pleased.
Because it's a dramatic.
It's dramatic. Wow. It's scary. It's a little bit like The Terminator. So I hope you all come, all of you, everywhere. It's called Deception.
It's called what?
Deception.
Deception. And it'll be out like in a couple weeks, right?
Yeah,
it takes a long time to get something like that.
Yes, it'll be out probably by the end of this year.
Really?
Yeah.
That's really quick. And you brought a clip from
your newest movie.
Yes, it's called The Squeeze, for all the executives in New York who are watching, Boss. It's called The Squeeze, and I star with Michael Keaton. And it's a comedy, and it's about the lotto. It's about a lotto. It's a mystery. You got to come and see it. I think it's really good. I've seen it, so I can say I like it. And,
Telephone.
I've just lost my next job.
Excuse me.
Hello?
Who's this? Oh, Kevin, hi, how's it going?
Good, who's this?
This is Pee Wee Herman.
Okay.
Is this wrong number or what?
No, not at all. Do you know who I am?
No, I don't.
You don't know who I am. Do you know Garth Ancier?
No.
Welcome you to our show. We're in charge of Fox.
Oh, really? Oh, of course I remember you.
Listen,
we're on the air right now. Are you aware of that fact?
Well, can I call you back?
We are on the
Please
air.
Hold.
Could you set this clip up for us?
Okay. Any further? Kevin's on hold. Let's see. We're being chased by Meatloaf, who plays the bad guy.
You and Michael Keaton are being chased by Meatloaf.
Meatloaf.
Oh, by Meatloaf.
Yeah. By Meatloaf. No, by Meatloaf.
Okay. We could probably figure it out, right?
Yeah.
Let's just I'll stall them so they can't get on the boat.
Wait. No, Harry! Harry! Come back! Harry, come on! Hurry up! Harry,
Suzanne was a Girl Scout. Frankie was a Boy Scout. I didn't ask you, were you in the Cub Scouts or Boy Scouts, Howard?
I was in the,
Time's up. Were you in the Girl Scouts or Brownies?
Well, actually, my group of girls, I used to run in a very rough crowd, and what we used to do is we used to look at the Girl Scouts that looked like Suzanne. They used to live in our neighborhood, and we used to mug them for their cookies. And we take their cookies and sell them. And that's us. And
then you'd keep the money?
Yes, can you imagine what a rough kid I was? Well, there it was. Sorry, all the Girl Scouts we mugged.
We'll be right back right after these messages to hear about all the rest of the muggings that these people have done. Tomorrow night, Joan's guest host will be Louis Anderson. Yeah. And really giant talent, Louis, right? Get it?
Hi, Louis.
Joining him on tomorrow night's show will be Gene Kasem from the Tortellis, psychic Uri Geller, and musical group Lakeside. I would like to thank tonight's guests. This went by so quickly, I can't believe it. Thank you to Suzanne Summers. She's the sheriff, and your variety special coming up. Good luck with that.
Thank you.
Frankie Avalon, Back to the Beach. When was that?
Oh, that's July 17th.
July 17th. And also, Frankie will be spending his spring break reunion in Fort Lauderdale for 4 weekends with Connie Stevens, starting May 22nd. Ray Don Chong, what's the name of the movie?
The Squeeze.
The Squeeze, and good luck on your next upcoming project where you're going to be the producer. And Howard Hewitt, who is now going to perform Say Amen. Good night, everyone. Thanks for watching.
To say goodbye for now, we'll have our second time around. But before we go, there's something I'd like to say. Everything's not what it seems. There's a stronger force behind the scenes. He's in our lives every day. He's right there when you call. In Him is where my strength lies. I lift my eyes beyond the skies. Only He can save my life, and only He can hear my cry. I wanna thank You, God, for giving me one more chance to raise my voice and to sing Your praise. I sing it out loud. I sing it all day. Song is my prayer, I give the only know there's some who don't believe. Sometimes it's very hard to see. Live this old life every day. Some things don't go your way. But to be without is not his will. This cattle on a thousand hills, and they're all yours to claim. Just claim them in his holy name. See, you don't have to beg or crawl. No, no, no. He can see you standing proud and tall. He'll give his everlasting love. Just come to him as you are. I want to thank you, God, for giving me one more chance to raise my voice and to sing your praise. I say it out loud, hey, I sing it all day. This song is my prayer I give to only you. I know it can't compare to the gift from you.
Time is 11 o'clock.